Hello everyone, my name is Balaji. In this video, you will learn about Splunk fields, which is another knowledge object in Splunk. Let's understand what are Splunk fields. Fields appear in event data as searchable name value pairings such as user underscore name equal to Fred or IP underscore address equal to 192.168.1.1. Here, username is a field, Fred is a value of username field. IP address is a field, 192.168.1.1 is a value of IP address. Fields are the building blocks of Splunk searches, reports, and data models. When you run a search on your event data, Splunk software looks for fields in that data. You can see here lowercase a and hash before field names. Lowercase a before any field represents that the field contains alpha values, in other words, it contains string value. Hash before any field represents that the field contains numbers. You can see here selected fields and interesting fields. Let's understand what are selected fields first. When you first run a search, the selected fields list contains the default fields, host, source, and source type. These default fields appear in every event. As you can see here, under each event, those fields are appeared, highlighted in red color box. What are interesting fields? Interesting fields are fields that appear in at least 20% of the events. This is one of the Splunk exam question. It may be asked in user or power user or sometimes in admin exam also. Let's assume we have a source that contains 100 events. And the field action is available only in 15 events out of 100 events, which means field action is appearing in only 15% of events, hence action field will not be shown under interesting fields. We have another field, client IP, available in 30 events out of 100 events, which means field client IP is appearing in 30% of events, hence client IP will be shown under interesting fields. You can select any interesting field and that will show under selected fields. Same selected field will appear in each event if the field is available in that particular event. To select interesting or any field and to show under selected fields, first click on all fields here. Once you click on all fields, you will see window like this. You can select any number of fields which you want to show under selected fields. The selected fields appear under selected fields, as you can see here. And these selected fields will show up under each event if the field is available in the event. Look at first event here. Only host, source, and source type are shown up here. But the other fields, action, category ID, product ID are not showing up. That's because fields action, category ID, and product ID are not available in the first event. Look at second event, action field and product ID are not available because they might not be available in this event. To see field values, just click on any field. The new window will pop up and shows stats of that field. For example here, action field is selected. Under action, it is showing 5 values, 55.284%, which means the field action has total 5 unique values and the coverage is 55.284%, which means, for example, if there are 100 events, the field action is available approximately in 55 events. Right side, you can see radio button selected, which represents whether the field is selected or not. Currently, selected value is yes, means the field is selected. Under reports, these are pre-built reports. Data can be visualized if you click on these reports. For example, top values will show exactly the view you can see here under values. And this is equivalent to Splunk search top action. Under values, you can see by default top 10 values with their count and percentage. Look at the value purchase. It appears 70 times in total events, which is 34.314%. You got an idea what are Splunk fields now. Let's understand more features of Splunk fields knowledge objects. Field aliases, calculated fields. Field aliases. Let's understand field aliases properties. Why to create field aliases? How to create and use field aliases? How to manage field aliases? Field aliases properties. Field names are case sensitive. For example, these two are not same. User which is left to equal starts with uppercase U, and user which is right to equal starts with lowercase u. Another example, left side u and n are uppercase, right side all are lowercase. Field aliases is a way to normalize fields of multiple sources. You can see here, user field is common across all sources. Field aliases can be applied after field extractions and before applying automatic lookups. Why to create field aliases? Let's assume you have Windows security, VPN, proxy, and email logs. You have a common field, user, across all these sources. User field is in different format in each of these sources. For example, you want to see user activity from all these sources with current user fields. You have to write splunk search, something like this. It would be nice to get user Jack's activity from all the above sources by just typing user equal to Jack. For easy correlation and to see user activity in this example, normalizing field names are very important. This is one of the reasons we create field aliases. If we can alias these fields to user like this, then we can write simple search user equal to Jack. It will return user Jack's activity from all the above sources. How to create and use field aliases? I have sample events here from index equal to underscore internal and source type equal to splunkd underscore access. Let's create alias for client type as source. We can apply field aliases based on host, source, and source type meta fields. Most of the times we use source type to apply field aliases because source type is unique for same events. The reason for not preferring host because there could be one more host sending same kind of data. If that is the case, we need to write two field aliases for same field using two different hosts. Same applies for source as well. Now let's take source type to create field alias for client IP. Copy this, go to settings and fields, click on field aliases, new field alias, destination app, let it be search. And I'm going to create src source type, paste the source type which you copied, field aliases client IP. You want to create a field alias for this field, that is client IP, and it should be renamed to src. Save it. Let's go back to our search. Let's run this again, expand this. Can see here src has been created. You can see both fields now, client IP and src. This is how you can create field aliases using Splunk Web. Let's look at this in CLI, how this has been written in the configuration file. We created that in the search application. Let's go back to search, local. This might have been created in props.conf. Let's open props.conf. The reason why we are not seeing this here, because the field alias which we created here, you can see permission here, it is private. That means the owner admin has not shared this object with anyone. Let's see in that case where this will be available in the file system. Users and then admin. And you can see all the apps here. It should be under search application. Let's go to search and then local. You can see here props.conf. Let's open props.conf. You can see here, this is a source type in between brackets. And you can see field alias hyphen src. This is the name I used while creating this field alias, saying the client IP as new source. For example, let's try to create a field alias for this method from the CLI. Let's rename this to test method, something like that. Since we are going to apply this to the same source type, you can just copy this one and paste it here. can say field alias test method equal to method as new test underscore method. Let's save this. Let's go back to Splunk web. To get the effect from this change, either we need to restart Splunk or we can do debug refresh by just typing debug refresh, something like this. To do debug refresh, it should be logged in as admin. Let's click on refresh. It may take some time. Let's go back to our search and run it again. Let's expand this. You can see test underscore method has been created. Now you know how to create field aliases using Splunk Web and CLI. Let's understand how we can manage these field aliases. If I refresh this one, I should see two field aliases. The one I have created from Splunk Web and the one I have created from CLI. Let's understand how we can manage these field aliases. You can see here it is saying that sharing is private, private. That means the object, whatever you have created here, this is owned by admin and this cannot be seen by anyone in the Splunk enterprise. For example, there is one more user and he wants to see this and he wants to make use of this field alias. He cannot see that. The reason, because it is kept private. If you want to share this object with anyone, just click on permissions. Here you can see objects should appear in keep private, this app only, all apps system. You can make it all apps so that it would be available in all applications. On the permissions, you can say that everyone can read and only admin can write or change this configuration. Let's save this. Now you can see sharing is global. If you want to see this configuration in the file system, it will not be appeared under users. It will appear in etc apps search. Let's open the vaprops.conf again. You can see here it's not available. The only which is kept as private is available here. Let's go back to search application, etc apps search, local vaprops.conf. You can see here the configuration has been moved to search local props.conf. Next one is calculated fields. Why to create calculated fields? How to create and use calculated fields? How to manage calculated fields? Let's understand why to create calculated fields. For example, you have a source type proxy and you have fields like bytes in, bytes out, and you want to calculate total bytes from these two fields. You have to write Splunk search something like this. Eval total underscore bytes equal to bytes in plus bytes out. For example, daily you are making use of this proxy logs and you are creating multiple reports. Every time if you want to write this eval statement, it would be a little bit difficult. That's why in Splunk we create calculated fields so that the total underscore bytes would appear in the field section. Let's look at another example for the same source type. We have a field status and you want to get action where if status equal to 200, action value should be success, otherwise failed. You can do this in Splunk by writing below search eval action equal to if status equal to 200 success, otherwise failed. And again, if you are generating multiple reports using proxy data daily and every time writing this statement or adding this statement to all your searches, it would be a difficult process. In Splunk, we create calculated fields and this new field action will appear in field section. Let's understand how to create calculated fields. To create calculated fields using Splunk Web, you have to click on fields again and you can see here calculated fields. You can see here there is a status field. The status field contains HTTP status codes. And we know that 200 and 201 are success, 404 is failed. Let's create a calculated field, status underscore message, where it says if status equal to 200 or 201 success, 404 failure. To do that, let's go back to calculated fields, click on new calculated field, destination app, let it be search, apply to source type, let us copy this splunk-d axis, paste it here, and name status underscore message. This is the new field which we are going to create. Expression if status equal to 200 or status equal to 201 set success, otherwise failed. Let's save this. As explained before, this is private now. Whenever you create an object, make sure that at least you share it in that particular application. For now, I'm going to keep this for all apps and everyone can read, admin can write. Let's save this. Let's go back to our search. Run this search. Expand the first event. You can see here status equal to 200 and status underscore message equal to success. Let's open status underscore message here. We can see only success and failed. If you count 200 and 201, you can see 589 and 404 is 23. Let's go to status message. It's a 589 and 23, which is matched. Let's go back to CLI and see how we can create from the CLI. Even calculated fields are stored in props.conf only. Let me open props.conf. You can see here, we applied this calculated field for source type splunk-d underscore access. You can see eval hyphen status underscore message equal to if status equal to 200 or status equal to 201. Success, otherwise failed. Let's try to create one more field here for the same status field. I'll copy this. I'll paste it here. This time, for demonstration purpose, I'll name it as status underscore message underscore CLI. Let's save this. Again, we need to do debug refresh. Remember, if you want to do debug refresh, you should be logged in as admin. It may take some time. Let's go back to our search. Run it again. Expand the first event. And you can see here, status underscore message underscore CLI success. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.